Now, all of us know a lot about gravity because we've been dealing with gravity from, well, the time we were born. It makes things go to the earth and go down. Now, this happens in water, too, that we do have gravity. We do have principles of going down. But the principle of gravity from here changes as soon as I touch the water because now I have buoyancy, which is an upward force, is lifting on it. My hand is very, very, very heavy, 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 and then it becomes light as soon as it's in the water. Gravity still works. I still fall, and this is normal. But we want to be in touch with and understand, what is it that the lightness of water, this is the effect of buoyancy. So even if you're not a, quote, good floater, which usually people have the image in their head of being flat to the surface of the water as a good floater, on our roadmap to learning to swim, we want to understand how gravity still works and how much gravity does take your body down for how long and for how far. We don't start it in the deep end. We start it over here in the shallow end to allow the gravity, once you're in the water, that is then combined with the force of buoyancy. Why is this important? It's important so we're not trying to fight gravity. I'm getting older and we all like want to fight gravity, but it's just not possible, right? Physics, we can't fight physics, but we can understand it and then start to work with it. When I jump into the water, there is going to be fast gravity in the air and then slower gravity once I hit the water because I will have buoyancy acting on me. I want to feel for where that gravity takes me and then feel the time when buoyancy overcomes the force of gravity and allow the naturalness of this to happen. This helps me understand how the water works, which is part of the foundation that you need on your roadmap to being a successful swimmer.